Hello and welcome back to the Linux Panic YouTube channel. In this video I'm going to be going over how to install Lutris on any Debian based operating system. In this case I'll be using Ubuntu. But first, don't forget to hit like and subscribe and so you don't miss out on any future videos. So you're probably wondering, what is Lutris? Well, as we can see here, is what Lutris is advertising themselves as. It's a video game preservation platform aiming at keeping collections alive for the many years to come, even if they have been killed off by their developers. Looking at you, Nintendo. Over the years, video games have gone through a lot of hardware and software platforms. This is very true. So what Lutris does is it makes most of these installable on Linux. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set it up and show you how it's done, and we're going to install Epic Games on Ubuntu, if believe it or not. So first what we're going to do is we're just going to install Neofetch just to make sure everything's working fine. I'm going to tell it yes. I'm going to tell the updater tool to remind me later because I have just updated it, so I don't know what it's talking about. So as we can see here, thankfully on the downloads page it goes through the various ways of installing Lutris, all the way from source, tarball, every Linux variation you could think of, there is a way to do it, which I very much like. But in this case, we're just installing on Ubuntu, although the Debian variation would work in this case as well, because Ubuntu is Debian-based, so it would also work using Debian. But in this scenario, I'm going to be using the Ubuntu method. As we can see here, we're running on Ubuntu 22.04 long-term support in the 64-bit edition. We're running kernel 5.15.0. I've not changed the kernel or anything. It's just the install I used for when I installed Wine. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to type in this command here. So we're going to do sudo add apt repository. If I could spell pba lutris-team/lutris. Command not found. Help if I could. Yep, that's why. It would help if I could spell correctly. There we go. So now what it's doing there is just getting everything it needs. It says, hey, look, here's this thing. Here's the thing as a description. I want to add that, so we're going to hit enter, not shift. That would help. And now it's just getting all the necessary packages it needs from Canonical. So what it's just going to, as we can see here, it took everything down. So now we need to update our system. So it just sees the packages available. Which again, this will take seconds because it's Linux. It's no bother at all. These things don't take an age like they do on Windows. Now we're going to install Lutris. So in the time it's taken for me to go through the install process for Lutris would be most likely be faster than doing it on Windows itself. Now, you wouldn't need to install Lutris on Windows anyway because it's Linux based, but it'd still be faster on Linux anyway. That's just my personal opinion. So whilst we wait for it to install, the method, it even includes a Steam OS method, which is pretty good considering Steam OS hasn't actually been out for the Steam Deck that long, relatively less than a year. So it's pretty good that it's there already. It's part of the Arch. It's part of the Arch based ones as well as OpenSUSE, Fedora, Clear. That one I'm not going to butcher the name of. Gen 2, CentOS, surprised it still exists, CentOS, considering Red Hat killed off CentOS Slack Tarball. It's just there for everything you could want, which is very nice. So that's just continuing by going through the process. That's nearly done. It's taking as long as it needs to take for it. It's just waiting for the user. It's just waiting for the packages to come from Ubuntu. This part does take the longest. It just, you know, the servers can't be maximum all the time, you know. so this will take a short while, but it's no bother. So the wonderful thing about Lutris is you can choose what you want to be inside your Lutris install. So for example, if we were to go to games, for example, we could choose any game that we wanted to. So in this case, I am just going to search for newest. Just going to do a quick search. And as we can see here, apparently Wallace and Gromit has been added on as a recently playable thing for Lutris, which I find rather funny. So, but these are the available things if we choose, oh, I don't know, Anno 1800. It's a game I like to play myself. And as you can see here, it's available. It was made available by Blue Byte, but it was published by Ubisoft. This is, if you've watched any of the Linus Tech Tip videos, Anno 1800 is a game that Linus himself likes. It's a game I like as well. So it's nice that it works. So as we can see here in the terminal, it is done doing what it is needed to do. So all we're going to do is just type Lutris, hit enter, and it says, oh look, I'm missing Vulkan libraries. So we're going to follow the guide to installing graphics drivers. And luckily, it just takes us straight through to where we need to go, which is very nice. As I'm not running a NVIDIA card because it's NVIDIA, why would I want to do that? We're just going to click copy, paste it here, hit enter. And this shouldn't take long at all. Yes, I'd like to do that, please. Because these are all just drivers, it's just no bother at all. It'll just install straight away. Absolutely no bother. And as we can see here, it's already started to go through and get everything it needs. Really rather fast, actually. So it's got all the PPAs required. It's just going through and having a chat with WineHQ. Yes, please download those 229 megabytes. Now, this may be something that you get depending on what graphics card you're using, because I'm using an AMD based graphics card. It's like, hey, look, can you just get me the drivers, please? That's no bother. It's just, as you saw, just quick click the link, click the copy for the message for the one you're using. In my case, I just needed to click the top one, download that. As you can see, it's just saying yes. All you need to just say yes to it constantly. There's no hassle, there's none of that. It's just working as intended, and it's done. So all we need to do now is click okay, and it's just going to check to see if there's any updates. And what we're going to do next is I'm going to log into the Lutris launcher, into the Lutris software, so I can then check my Lutris libraries and check for the pieces of software that I have downloaded, well, I've added to my library, and go from there with it. So what we're going to do is just going to reopen all my previous tabs. If I can remember how to do that. Oh, well, it's fine. This is going through. Now, this may take a while. It may take 5 seconds, depending on how often you use Lutris, or if you just launch it the first time. Because I'm launching it for the first time this time, it's taking a little bit of extra time because it's not done a first launch yet. So, well, here we go. Now it's open. So to launch into, log into the software, you just come here, click the thing, stick in your username and password. Make sure I actually hit enter, and here we go. As we can see, here's the software. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to install the Epic Game Store. It's going to ask me, hey, look, do you want to do the standard one, as this is the only available one? We're just going to go, yep, please install. Thanking of you, and it's just going to go through and get what it needs to. It's just as simple as that, really. 90 megabytes, it's not going to take too long at all. We're just going to tell it to wait, and as we can see here, here's what we need. We're just going to click continue. It's getting the Ubisoft Connect installer because it recognizes, hey, look, there might be some games on the Epic Games Store in your and also in your library that need Ubisoft Connect. So we're just going to get that now. I can tell you that is so nice to have, because trying to use a game that has Ubisoft Connect on Linux is a pain in the ass if you don't have Ubisoft Connect installed through Lutris. It is incredibly, incredibly annoying not having it installed with Lutris. Like, it really is. I should know there's a couple games I wanted to try with that didn't have Ubisoft Connect, such as Anno 1800. So I'm glad it chose to install it. And as we can see here, it's just going through the process of getting everything it needs, making sure it's going to work, just installing. And that's just saying, hey, look, this is what I'm doing, getting all the exes and registry files and all the Epic Games stuff that's going to be needed. So this shouldn't take more than a couple minutes because of the size of it, really. But once it's done and installed, you don't need to launch it through Lutris from here on. Once it's installed, it'll just work. I've had no issues with it. I mainly use Epic Games through Lutris on Manjaro. You can find that in a earlier video of mine. I'll stick it up in the top right hand corner here. You should see it pop up around about now. But I use Epic Games Store on Manjaro. It just works without any hassle at all. I've used it to play Hitman, which I also used for a previous video, for a benchmarking video. You may go back and search for that one, because I can't do two cards at once. I've also used it for Hitman, as previously mentioned, and Anno 1800. The multiplayer, whilst I was trying to use it, worked no bother at all. But it was causing issues for Mr. Linus over at Linus Tech Tips. So that is something I was happy about. But once it's just at this point, it's just waiting for this to go through the processes and say, hey, look, I'm done. Now, as exited process, so we're just going to give it a second here. There we go. We just saw the Epic Games icon going, hey, look, I'm installing. I'm updating. I'm installing. Give me a second. So as we can see here, I also have other options here, such as Battlefield 4. That does work straight out of the box, which I very much like. I had honestly no issues running Battlefield 4 on Manjaro either. It just is infinitely better, in my opinion. So now that we've selected it, all we need to do is just tell it to play, and then it should just launch Epic Games. It should. So this may take a while. If it doesn't want to launch, we can just come here and just say, hey, look, open. And as we can see here, it's going through the configuration. Yes, install Wine Mono. We've already installed it, but that was for Lutris. Now we're installing it as for the rest of the system. It's just taking as long as it'll take. And it's just going through the configuration process. And as we can see here, multiple crashes detected. No, do not. Unsupported graphics card. Well, it does meet the minimum requirement standards. But oh well. Now, sometimes... unsupported graphics card. So sometimes this may become an issue. The problem with graphics card, that's the thing. My RX 570 may no longer meet the minimum standards required for Epic Games. Which, if it doesn't meet the minimum standards, that is a bit of a shame, because they've they've moved the goalposts. So as we can see here, we're getting the spinny, which means it is still trying to do something. Unsupported graphics card, that's fine. So in this case, Epic Games still no longer works because it doesn't like my graphics card, which is fine. So we'll tell Battlefield 4 that we want to launch, and it's just going to go through the process of, yes, please install DXVK. DXVK, DVX, whatever it is. And it's just going to download everything we need. It's not going to be any bother at all. Just go through the process of downloading and installing. As we can see here, it's creating the Y configuration needed for Battlefield 4. Now, what I love, you don't need to go through any extra hassle. You don't need to go download Origin and log in there and get the thing done. It downloads it all. Just one shot, no bother. Yes, I'm using an AMD card. As you can see, I'm not, I don't actually have enough space left. But installing games and setting up stuff on Lutris for like Debian based ones, it is just as easy as this. Now, my issue with Epic Games Store, it doesn't like my graphics cards. Epic Games may have changed where they stand on the graphics card front, which if they had, that's unfortunate. But unfortunately, it is what it is in these times. Like, we know these game manufacturers and game stores like to change the goalposts. If this was through Steam, wouldn't be any bother at all. However, it's not. So there we are. So I'd like to thank you very much for watching. Make sure you click the subscribe button. Don't forget to hit the like if you liked it. Hit the dislike if you didn't. That button works as well. Ring the notification bell so you don't miss out on any future videos. I'd like to thank you very much for watching, and I hope you have a good rest of your day. Goodbye.